shots
right
there.
Me, 160 pounds, pro TKD, MVP last year. 93 national champion.
Those shots take a lot out of you.
98 Canadian Open champion. Give it up for Don Sapnee.
Sitting here from Mesquite, Texas. Don has been a national player since the late 80s. 10 years later, at 30 years old, he's still doing it. We went to Canada in August. Don decided that he went as a coach and decided at the last minute to compete and came in with a silver medal, losing to the world champion in the finals by 1 point. Well, some people would consider it on the downside, but I'll tell you something. Don has kept himself in such good health, and he continuously trains. He has never stopped training for 1 minute. The guy is in phenomenal condition. 30 years old. There's a lot of 20-year-olds that would like to be in this kind of shape. He won't get tired, and you'll want to see. You'll see him control the ring. He's a master at controlling the ring. George Bell's a little more wild.
29 years old, two-time national medalist, and again, fierce competition from the get-go here.
That's right. Well, George has wanted to fight with Don because he thinks he's a little too smooth and too much of a technician. So you've got a guy from Philly versus Dallas here. George also at the last pro TKD. Oh, that's going to be a five-pointer right there. That score, that back spinning hook kick to George Bell's face, that's going to be 5 points. Dong is famous for that kick. That's what made him MVP at the last event.
Be interesting to see what George does this year. Last year, he was such a counterpuncher, and it got him into trouble.
That's right. You can see how he's moving back a little bit. He's getting close to the edge. Now, Dong is also, not only is he skilled, he's very smart. He's very tactical in the ring. You can see how he keeps himself in the center of the ring. See where he's in the center of the ring? He keeps George at the edge. What that's going to do is put him in a position to push George out of the ring. And he's either going to dunk. He's got a terrific right leg back kick and a terrific left leg spinning kick. Spinning hook kick, which is where he's going to turn. He's going to go right up to the head. There he goes again. Another 5 points. George shaking his head no, but I think the judges are going to differ with him on that. That was right to the jaw. Again, you see how Dong is in the center of the ring. George is off at the corner. He's going back to his... You know, when you fight as a counterfighter for so many years, George tries the cut kick back kick, placing his foot on Dong Lee's hip and trying to hit him in the face at the same time. It's not working. George comes in with a double kick.
Come on. Good. Okay? Awesome. Basket. If you're not getting a basket, go change it in double kick after that. Okay?
Double.
Cut.
1, 2.
If you move back, come back. And then if you set, the front leg, right kick. Front leg.
Yes, sir.
Just go from there, just straight up to the face. That's all you do.
He said, no problem.
George just got done rehabbing his knee at the Olympic Training Center this summer. That might have an effect on his condition. As I said earlier, Dong Lee, never out of shape, always at the top of his game. And we've got a score of George Bell with 6-6.
You surprised by that?
Wow, I'm very surprised by that. I thought they would have given Dong Lee the 10 points. 2 5-point shots for those back spinning kicks. Apparently they only scored one, and perhaps a roundhouse kick or a solid punch, but we've got a tie score going into round two.
Red, blue, what's up?
George Bell and blue, Dong Lee on the
red. Let's keep that clean. Jump.
And we're off again. Again. There you go. You can see one thing that's going to really weigh heavily in Dong Lee's favor. He stays in the center of the ring and controls the distance and controls the ring management. Missing narrowly with that back kick. But you can tell.
So if you're George Bell, how do you combat that?
George Bell's got to use, he's got to be a little bit more aggressive. He's got to attack first. He's got to come in. He's got to. Almost again, Dong Lee missing closely with that back hook kick. But George has to come in. He's got to attack. He's got to shut Dong Lee's offense down and then score some points off his attack. That's going to be -5 points for George
Bell
right
off
there.
Sure. That. Have there been a lot of people in this sport successful being participating as counterattackers?
Some people have. You know, but usually in anything, the more aggressive fighter, the more attempts you make, the more points you're going to get. If all you do is sit back for that 1 or 2 point shot every time, it's really going to be it's hard for you to win. It's hard for you to consistently score points because people will learn how to shut down your counterattack very quickly. But we've got we saw funnier things at the end of that round. I thought we would have had at least 10 points for Dong Li. We see a tie score. George Bell went off the mat. That should be negative 5 points. We'll see what happens. Jordan with a nice counter roundhouse kick underneath Dong Li's attack.
Final seconds of the second round.
Fight it up.
Dong Li may have to pick it up in the third round, depending on how the score comes out.
That's how this comes out.
This will be interesting. Going into the next week, Jason Lee talking to George Bell. He's smiling. He's very happy with the end of the first round score.
When you're tired and you wore out, and then you're like, that's how you gotta kind of stretch. But people outside the ring, it's not coming to good. Watch, front leg, you're not using the left leg axe kick to the face.
Okay.
You're not doing it at all. The other one is motion. Dungeon kick. Right away.
You need to step in and you need to double kick.
After the first round, 6 points! 6 points!
Push him out! Get him over there!
10 points for Dong Li.
You can't imagine 5 points.
And six, and then
after the second round, okay, the 10 points. 10 points.
10-10 tie.
That's interesting. I'm wondering if they're going to score that back and George went off the mat in the back.
Red, blue,
so it looked from here. You have Master Jason Lee in between the rounds, telling George Bell to use his left leg axe kick to the face. Let's see if he listens. He told him to check and draw motion from Dong. Together, George smiling, thinking he's got the advantage. We've got a minute 15 left and a tie score.
Well, it's been the most aggressive George Bell has been.
I've never seen George this aggressive. He really wanted to make a statement when he came up here. Last year, not only was he a counterfighter, but he seemed to run out of a little gas. He's been working real hard to rehab that knee, and here we go. Dong Li standing in the center of the ring. Coach Han Wan Lee trying to tell them to get the action going.
Final 50 seconds here, the third and final round.
George trying to attack with that jump axe kick to the head to go for the big five-pointer. Dong Li scoring with the roundhouse kick, the hook kick just missing by George Bell.
30 seconds.
I think Dong running into a little bit more formidable George Bell than he expected.
So he scored with that one. Shot to the body. Did he think that earned him a couple of points?
It might have only scored 1 point on that one. But they've surprised me before. The chief.
Let's go, gentlemen. Let's
15
go.
Seconds.
Oh, they just, let's go. I don't know what's going on there. They changed the score for blue. Final 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Dong Li trying to take it off the ring again.
Hello.
Good match.
Very good match. Exciting match.
Hey, strong. Come on.
You have two international champions, George Bell meddling at the U.S. Open,
score,
Dong Li meddling at the
seven,
Canadian Open and the U.S.
10,
Open several times.
The winner, Red 10.
That was the end of the second round.
Okay.
Tracy Morgan, our ring announcer.
Oh, excuse me.
Just a little still premature tally, on the score. He's reading the scorecard from the scoreboard from the first two rounds.
Have money bet on the ring.
the third round results. They'll tally them and we'll come out with a winner here momentarily.
George Bell and Dong Li waiting for the results.
I think it was 10-10.
You know, Dong not only is an outstanding competitor, he's a coach. He's got two athletes on the national team, one on the A team, one on the B team. So not only is he a champion himself, but he's producing champions.
We have the
champions.
Score now. Blue 15, red 12. The winner is blue 15.
And what a surprise. That's a surprise. They only gave Dong Li 2 points, and George Bell got 5 in that last round. I'll tell you,
the turning point for you, you thought that he was knocked out of the ring, costing him the 5 points, and they did not judge that he had gone out of the ring.
Absolutely, that's a 5-point differential that would have given Dong Li the win.
Well, there's a break.
Yeah.